all of you are. Now is story time. And I want to tell you a story, a Bible story about Jacob. The story is brought to you by Samuel Academy. It is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 25, verse 27, to Genesis chapter 50, verse 13. Welcome as we go through. We shall be referring to this map of Israel as we look at the story of Jacob. All right, let's begin. Jacob's father, his name was called Isaac, and his mother was called Rebekah. Jacob had a brother called Esau, or Esau. He liked to stay at home, but his brother was a cunning hunter, a man of the field. Jacob was loved by his mother, and Esau was loved by his father. Jacob asked his brother to sell him his birthright, and Esau, his brother, exchanged his birthright with the bread and pottage of lentils. So Jacob beguiled his father that he was Esau in order to receive the blessing. The blessing was meant for the firstborn. His father blessed Jacob instead of Esau, the firstborn. His name, that is Jacob, means supplanter, or the one who takes the place of someone else. He took away the blessing and birthright of his brother Esau. His mother advised him to flee to his uncle Laban in Haran, because Esau conspired to kill him. So he went out from Beersheba. Can you see Beersheba is down here? Just around here, that is Beersheba. So he went out from Beersheba and went toward Haran. Haran is in Syria, north of Israel. In the evening, Jacob lodged at Luz or Bethel. So he lodged at this place, Bethel or Luz. Bethel means house of God. He took stones and used them for a pillow and slept. He dreamt of a ladder that stood and reached to heaven. On the ladder, he saw angels of God ascending and descending. He heard the voice of the Lord, who stood above the ladder, promise that he would give him the land where he lied, and that his descendants would be as many as the dust of the earth, and in him would all the families of the earth be blessed. When he arrived in Haran, Jacob came near a well. At the well, he helped to roll away a stone from the mouth of the well and water the flock of sheep that belonged to Rachel, the daughter of his uncle Laban. Jacob revealed to her that he was Rebekah's son. When Laban heard about him, he welcomed him into his home. Laban asked Jacob to stay with him and promised to give him his daughter Rachel in marriage. When the time came for Laban to honor his promise, he beguiled Jacob and gave him his other daughter, Leah. Jacob accepted to serve his uncle for 7 more years in order to be given Rachel, whom he loved most. Besides Rachel and Leah, Jacob had other wives, Bilhah and Zilpah. They were the maids of Rachel and Leah. Now Jacob had 12 sons and one daughter called Dinah. After some time, the Lord told Jacob to return to the land of his fathers, and the Lord promised to be with him there. Jacob left Haran with his four wives, children, and possessions. At Mahanaim, Jacob was met by the angels of the Lord. He sent messengers to meet Esau, his brother. When they returned after meeting Esau, they told him that Esau had 400 men with him. And this made Jacob much afraid and distressed. In this situation, he prayed. He prayed unto the Lord to deliver him from his brother Esau. He sent messengers again ahead of him with the gifts to present to his brother with the hope of appeasing him. Near the brook of Jabbok, this should be the brook of Jabbok, he wrestled with a man the whole night until daybreak. The man did not prevail against Jacob. So the man touched the hollow of Jacob's thigh so that it was out of joint. These things happened at a place called Peniel. This Peniel, okay, where Jacob's name was changed to Israel, and the man blessed him there. Because Jacob told him, "You will not go until you bless me." When Jacob came near his brother Esau, they embraced one another and kissed each other and wept. Jacob pleaded with Esau to receive gifts he had brought to him. He urged him until Esau accepted the gifts. Esau returned to Seir, that is his country, the place where he was living, Seir, the hill country of Seir. Alright? And Jacob journeyed to Sukkoth. Alright? We can see where Sukkoth is on the map. This Sukkoth. He journeyed to Sukkoth and made a house and built booths for his cattle there. He pitched his tent at Shalem in Shechem and erected an altar and called it El Elohe Israel. God told Jacob to go and live in Bethel and build an altar there. When he came to Bethel, he built an altar and called the place El Bethel. From Bethel, Jacob journeyed to Ephrath or Bethlehem. This is where Bethlehem is, or Ephrath. Bethlehem. Okay. So from Bethel, Jacob journeyed to Ephrath or Bethlehem, and Bethlehem means house of bread. And that is where Rachel was delivered of Benjamin, and she died. So Rachel died at Bethlehem when she was being delivered of Benjamin. And Rachel was buried in Bethlehem. Jacob went unto Isaac, his father, in Mamre. You can see where Mamre is on the map. Okay. So he went to his father in Mamre, in Hebron. Alright. And Hebron was previously called Arba. Jacob loved Joseph more than all his children and made him a coat of many colors. His sons sold Joseph to the Ishmaelites and beguiled him or deceived him that an evil beast had devoured him. So Jacob mourned for many days and he refused to be comforted. There was famine in the land of Canaan. So Jacob sent his sons to Egypt to buy some grain. In Egypt, the sons of Jacob found that their brother Joseph was alive and that he was the prime minister in the land. God spoke to Jacob at Beersheba. Beersheba is here. So Jacob was going to Egypt and God spoke to him just to assure him. Okay? He spoke to him at Beersheba in visions at night and told him not to fear to go down to Egypt. Jacob went to Egypt with all his family and was settled in the base of the land of Egypt by his son Joseph. He was settled in Goshen in Egypt. Alright? Goshen is around the Nile Delta in Egypt. Before Jacob died, he blessed Ephraim and Manasseh, the sons of Joseph. He also blessed the rest of his sons. As he blessed Judah, his son, he prophesied the coming of Shiloh, or the Anointed One. And we know that Shiloh is actually our Lord Jesus Christ. He instructed Joseph to bury him in the land of Canaan when he would die. Jacob died, and Joseph and his brothers took his body to Canaan and buried him in the cave of the field of Machpelah near Mamre. So that is the end of the Bible story. I'm sure you have been blessed. So I request you to like, to leave a comment, to share widely, and to subscribe to support Bible stories for our children and even adults. Thank you so much.